Hello class 7, this is your science class and the topic today which we are going to study is fertilization in plants, page number 29, chapter reproduction in plants. Fertilization in plants. As we know that the surface of the stigma in a flower is sticky, so the pollen grains get stick to it. Now these pollen grains grow outward to form the pollen tube. These pollen tubes contain the sperms. So whenever these pollen grains reach downward, moving through the style of a flower, they releases the sperm after reaching the ovary where the ovules are present. The released sperm combines with the egg to form the zygote. This is the process of fertilization, which further leads to the formation of seed. Certain events which occur after fertilization, such as petals, sepals, stamens, they dry off and fall. The fertilized egg inside the ovary develops into the embryo, and this embryo develops into the seeds. Ovary then grows large and develops into the fruit. Now the seeds are present inside the fruit. These fruits further germinate to form a new mature plant. Now come the question answers. Write a note on fertilization in plants. Pollen grains stick to the stigma and pollen tube grows out from each pollen grains. Two sperm present in pollen tube. The pollen tube grows downward through style. It enters the ovary and releases the sperm in the ovule. One of the sperm combined with the egg to form the zygote. This picture is the clear illustration how the pollination through certain pollinators will bring about the fertilization process in the plants. You can draw this picture from the page 29 of your book. Next, what changes occur after fertilization? After fertilization, following changes take place in the flower. The sepal, petals and stamens dry off and fall off. The fertilized egg inside the ovary develops into embryo. Ovules become seed. The ovary grows large and develops into the fruit. And the fruit protects the seeds present in the plant.